Hi everyone, in this video I'll show you how to add grid cells of particular sizes onto your study area map. So many of you have asked me how to do that because in one of my previous videos I didn't quite explain well about adding grid cells of particular size. So in this video I'm going to clear your doubt regarding this topic. So first of all, as you can see in this gray color, this is the study area or the shapefile of my study area. I created it or I cropped it out of the OSM standard baseline map. So if you want to know how to crop or select or create a particular shapefile of your study area from a base map like OSM, it's explained clearly in one of my previous videos. I have provided the link below in the description. So once you are done with creating the shapefile of your study area, just uncheck the base map. And now you have to draw your map by going to print layout. So this is where we are going to draw our map and add grids. So I'm drawing the map. So it has come here. So the next step is adding grids. For that you can go to item properties and then go to grids, add a new grid, then click modify grid. Here if you take a look, you can see CRS. It stands for coordinate reference system. So there are a lot of different types of coordinate reference systems. However, here we are going to use this particular CRS, EPSG3857. You can also use the same, and this project CRS will be similar to what we have seen here. You can see here, right? So this is going to be our project CRS. So when we create our map as well, we use the same CRS. And the interval. So this interval stands for the size of your grid cell. So here you can see it's in map units. So in the case of this particular coordinate reference system, which is EPSG3857, our one map unit is equal to 1 meter. So if you want to add a grid cell of size 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer, so the value you are going to enter in these two fields, X and Y, should be in meters. So if I enter here 2 by 2, see, nothing happens. You can see two thick dark lines. So it's because the size is just 2 meters. So instead I want to add a grid cell of size 20 kilometers. So 20 kilometers is equal to 20,000 meters. So I'm entering 20,000 by 20,000, it's in meters. Then you will get a grid cell of size 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer. Here you can reduce the transparency of your grid cells, it will look better. And if you want to check whether your size of your grid cell is exactly 20 by 20, you can use this scale bar, add scale bar, and add here. And if you zoom in, you can see the length of this scale bar is 20 kilometers. So you can see, it's approximately 20. There will be a little difference. I don't know why is that happening, but that doesn't matter. You don't have to consider it. So now we have simply created grid cells of 20 by 20 in size. So for some of you, this must be enough. But in reality, in addition to adding grid cells, you have to add coordinates also. So the usual way to add coordinates is by going to, if you scroll down, you can see this add coordinates option, grids. This is the grid we have just created now, modify grids. The value you can see 20,000 by 20,000 meters, which is 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer. And if you scroll down further, you can find this option called draw coordinates. And when you draw coordinates, You can notice I'm adding these coordinates inside the frame so that it will look better, and also arranging it vertically, especially the bottom and top coordinates. So if you take a closer look, you can see this is in decimal format. I'm not sure whether it's actually in decimal format. I have never seen something like this. So this is where the trouble begins. This is where you need to do a little mathematical calculation to fix this issue. For that, let's go back to our CRS, coordinate reference system. And here we will have to change this CRS, because in this CRS you will be able to add coordinates in only in these two formats, either in decimal or in decimal with suffix. That doesn't make any difference. So we need to add our coordinates in degree, minutes and second format. That's what everyone understands. Let's go back, and you need to change the CRS into this one, default CRS, EPSG4326. So I have changed it, and you can see the grids have been disappeared. So this is where you should focus. So in the case of this particular CRS, the interval is in map units. But unlike the previous CRS, which was EPSG3857, the map units were in meters. But in the case of this particular CRS, the map units are in degrees. So the value you are going to enter in the X and Y field should be in degrees. So if I put one here and one here, you can see the box, it's in degrees. So the difference between this line and this line will be in degrees. So how many kilometers are 1 degree? So 1 degree is 111 kilometers. So the distance between this line and this line will be 111 kilometers. So my question is, how you're going to add a grid cell of a size 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer when you can't enter your grid cell size here in meter or in kilometer? So all you can do is you have to enter in degrees. So this is where we have to convert our size of grid cell, which is 20 by 20, into degrees. And for that, I'm going to show you a simple mathematical calculation. So if you take a look at here, you can see 1 degree is equal to 111 kilometers. So here we have entered 1 and 1, which will create a grid cell of size 111 by 111. To make you understand this thing better, I'm going to enter 0.25 and 0.25. Now you can see we have entered 0.25, which is a quarter of a degree, and the grid cells have become smaller. And also you will notice another difference, that is the coordinates are appearing in the general format, what we are familiar with. So here you can find multiple options: decimal with suffix, degree minute, seconds with suffix. You can choose whatever format you want. This is so flexible. So I'm going to choose degree minute. And if you go back, but still the problem is that how do we create grid cells of size 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer? For that, I'm going to do a small mathematical calculation. Here you can check this table for reference, and here you can see 0.01 degree is equal to 1.11 kilometer. So how many degrees are 20 kilometers? That's our question. And if we find how many degrees are 20 kilometers, we can put that value in these X and Y fields, and we'll make our grid cells of size 20 by 20. So here I'm finding the I'm converting the 20 kilometers into degrees, and when I did this calculation, I got 20 kilometers is equal to 0.180180 degrees. So I'm copying this value. So if you want to add a grid cell of size 10 by 10, you can put just 10 here. And if you want to add a grid cells of size 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer, you can put 2 here. However, you should notice that the value you are putting here should be or must be greater than this value, which is 1.11 kilometer. So change this value accordingly based on your purpose of your study. So here I'm putting 20 kilometers, and I converted it into degrees. So 0.180. Okay, so I'm copying this and I'm going to paste it here, because this is going to be the size of my grid cells. Okay, done. So now we are looking at grid cells of size 20 kilometer by 20 kilometers, because we have converted 20 into degrees and then we put the values here. And this is how we get grids and coordinates in a way that is familiar to us. And in order to check the accuracy, you can once again add the scale bar. My previous scale bar is already there. You can use any of these. And see, it's 20. See, the distance is 20. So this is how you can create, you can add grid cells into your study area map. You know, the mathematical part is quite simple. You can just substitute this value and add your own value to convert the kilometers into degrees. And further, you can change the transparency of your grid cells, your, you know, coordinates and all. I'll show you how. So if you scroll down under this draw coordinates option, you can find font. And if you click it and reduce the transparency, you can see the transparency is getting reduced. Okay, similarly, you can reduce the transparency of your grid cells as well. So for that, I'm going to select it and modify grids. Then go to this option and you can reduce the transparency here. Done. And I need only one scale bar, so let it be here. So now we have completed our map. In some studies, you know, you might want to collect samples from each of these grids, or in particularly in camera trap studies, you employ one camera trap in each of these grid cells. So this is how you add grids onto your study area. And I believe that the doubt is cleared, and you can follow this method to create maps with grid cells of particular size. Thank you so much for watching.